Well, let's bring you right up to date with the team news, because there is so much of it. The flu bug robs Rangers of the major influences of Richard Gough and Brian Laudrup. Andy Gorham and Paul Gascoigne have made it though. So Celtic trying to end this run of 8 matches without a win over the old enemy, and in doing so trying to improve their chances of stopping Rangers making it 9 titles in a row. Headed forward by Petric. Albertz. Robertson with so many attacking instincts coming from the left side. So I've got a free kick.
I don't think you could argue with that one.
Albertz came here with a genuine reputation as a set-piece specialist. And Celtic's wall is 5 strong. But Albertz gets it through!
You won't see many free kicks at any harder than that.
That was awesome. Absolutely awesome. This is goalkeeper's side. This is Stuart Kerr's side. But it's hit with such pace and ferocity. Goalkeeper doesn't edge to the right very far, does he, if at all? But that ball is past him before he can move. Look at the goalkeeper's position. He sees it. It's on its way. Go and move. It's past.
McLaren here.
Well, McLaren's in trouble.
Di Canio. Oh, Gorham's fumbled, which is a surprise in itself.
Well, it might have been too easy for Andy Gorham.
Gascoigne challenged by Di Canio. And that from Ian Ferguson. And an object going onto the pitch. Moore and Petric going for it. Yeah, the goalkeeper now to Celtic. Got a free kick.
Go through the computer. It was hit fiercely. Just over 32 yards. It was quick.
Right, to get out loud as well. That was a shock to the Rangers followers. They might have been concerned. Well, they might be concerned here at Di Canio. They'll have to do better than that to get a goal. Gertland, who's not too keen on crossing the halfway line, but will want to check back and will need to check back. Cadete.
Well done, Petric. Yeah, good defending, that. He knew he was the last man, Petric. Di Canio was always looking to run in behind. And he just steps up, gets it absolutely right.
Well, there's been an incident with the ball being kicked by Gorham, and it hit Di Canio on the back. And Di Canio is the player singled out by the Rangers fans, as, and it's a compliment to him, really, the one they want to get at. Suddenly, it was an explosive moment. Di Canio saw it as deliberate, which it might well have been. Only Andy Gorham will truly know. He's getting the ball up to where the free kick was to be taken from. A deep one from Albertz. Positioning of the free kick. Di Canio. That's Stubbs, but it was all rather ponderous.
Now McCoy's did his job. He's obviously back there to charge it down. Offside. Just then, but he's obviously down, he charged the ball and he did his job really well. Stubbs has got a fearsome shot, there's no doubt about that, and Celtic will have worked on this free kick played along the line like that.
The type of contest that only Old Firm games bring. Well read by Stubbs. Ferguson. He can have a go here. Kerr was bunging to his left. One comes in from Di Canio. And Gorham comes with a strong fist. And he wants to go in looking for those who caught him. He had his eyes on the ball, so I'm not sure that he absolutely knew who he was looking for. Stubbs was the player who gave it everything according to the letter of their instructions. Stubbs survives. Gascoigne. He's played understandably within himself without ever being on the peripheries of the match. Cadet, now Di Canio. Clelland, Moore, it's given away rather cheaply, or is it? It was a miskick that was lucky, it reached McCoist, ran beyond Hannah. Robertson, Cadet. Oh, it's a mistake by Bjorklund. Di Canio, looking more promising for Celtic here. They've got plenty of players in the centre. Di Canio there, certainly able to take it behind. Earlier ball this time, Van Hooydonk! Good stop by Gorham, it's a terrific header.
That was a great header. Bjorklund was waiting for the ball, Van Hooydonk wasn't. He gets in front of the defender. Super header.
Back to Boyd. Van Hooydonk pulling away to the far post. Others in there as well. Oh. It was Di Canio behind Van Hooydonk initially. Hannah then has the shot.
What a save that was, Martin.
Again, Andy Gorham shuts out Celtic.
Such a problem for Celtic. You feel, Mark, they've got to believe they can score.
Boyd. Van Hooydonk. Cadet. Di Canio. They have scored! Full set of substitutions for Rangers. 15 minutes also left on the clock. Like a Hannah's gone into the back line.
It has, yeah.
Well, here's Albertz, and here's Anderson! Rangers back in front, 7 minutes to go. Suicide for Celtic.
And yet again, a wonderfully cool finish and a white-hot atmosphere. Just like Paulo Di Canio, the bounce there beats Jackie McNamara. But he wasn't taken with the shot. He was so aware of Bo Anderson's position. And that was a super shot.
McNamara to surely knock it straight back in, which he does. That's Phil O'Donnell. And connects, but there's no flags up.
Flags up. Ball comes back out from here. Oh, I tell you
that's
what.
That's not offside.
That is not offside.
Di Canio. McStay.
Half a chance for Paul McStay. I've seen him score from that sort of range.
There's another break on here. Can Rangers really wrap it up? It's Erik Bo Anderson again. A sensational appearance from the substitute. And no wonder Walter Smith embroils himself in the celebration. He has taken the game totally away from Celtic. It's 3-1.
Well, I have to say, Martin Albertz has certainly played his part in this game, hasn't he? A great free kick. And what a finish here as well. Lovely ball through. Keeper comes out. A cool head's needed. He watches him come across. Look at him. Looking at the keeper. He knows if he gets it past him, he must score.
Free kick to Celtic, but it's academic now. Tim McCluskey getting the wall back. Well, tonight's thrill started with a superb Rangers free kick. Van Hooydonk. Oh. Coming up with a splendid effort of his own and flying through the air again was the man in white.
Yeah, it's a lovely free kick. Pace and bend. And yet again, when Gorham's required, Gorham's there.
Well, Rangers have done it again. Very hard work. But they came good when it mattered. Erik Bo Anderson, their hero tonight. Two goals from the substitute. An almost embarrassed smile there as his teammates converge on him. But Jorg Albertz started it so encouragingly. And Rangers wreathed in smiles. Celtic have to take it on the chin again, hoping that they're not totally knocked out of title contention. But now they definitely need the help of other clubs to slow Rangers' proud progress. 3-1 the final score.